Uku, what are you investing in there? GameStop? Is that a good idea? I mean, I'm hearing that they're not doing too great. Really? You think you're gonna make money off of this just because of a Reddit post? Alright, well, I hope you do well. I don't think it's gonna work out, though. Okay, so perhaps investing in a startup company promising revolutionary cheese-flavored candles might not have been the best of financial decisions. So, to get my mind off of the amount of money I've probably already lost, let's move on with the video. Now, if you've been literally almost anywhere on the internet, whether it be Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, you've probably ran into these business investment type accounts where they have videos along the lines of, "Oh, you spent your money on this thing? That's not right. You should be investing your money." And that's not inherently terrible advice, but realistically, it doesn't help really anybody. And again, it's not because it's necessarily bad advice. It's more that nobody really knows how to do what they're suggesting you should be able to do. But that's why you're here, and that's why I'm making this video. I'm going to break down the basics of it and make it uber easy to understand. And frankly, after you understand the structure of how everything works, teaching yourself everything from there is a heck of a lot easier. It's really just this gateway portion of information that really keeps people from being able to do this. Past this point, being able to get better at this is a lot easier. It's just this one initial really large step that seems to trip people up. Now, before we begin, let me just cover some misconceptions. No, you do not have to be a genius person to be able to do this. No, you do not have to be a super rich person to be able to do this. No, you do not have to be an evil person to be able to do this. And no, you do not need to dedicate all of your time to be able to do this to some degree. Now, needless to say, you get out of it what you put into it. So, yeah, if you wanted to make it your entire job and live off of investing and trading, then yeah, you would have to dedicate a large portion of time to doing this. But if you want to just have some future security, then no, you're not going to have to go crazy spending all your time investing. And generally speaking, for the sake of future security, it will really behoove most people to do this to some capacity. Not to the point where they're like waking up really early, trading until the stock market closes, and then planning the moves for the next day. But, you know, a little bit of investing. Now, the part that most people kind of understand is you somehow, some way purchase a stock, and then you somehow, some way sell it, and that somehow, some way gets you money. So the first thing is people kind of have a hard time wrapping their head around what a stock is, understandably so, because it's not really a product and it's not really a service. So understanding really what it is, not the easiest thing in the world if you're not used to this kind of method of thinking. But in layman's terms, it's just that you give the company money for a portion of their company, and then when the company makes more money and becomes more profitable, your stock in that company becomes more profitable, and then you can sell it for more than you bought it for. Now, I want to make a full in-depth video on exactly what a stock is, just to make it a lot easier for people to digest, because even that explanation probably left a couple of you confused. But luckily, you don't really need to understand exactly what a stock is to be able to do this. You just need to understand that you can buy it and then sell it for more money than you can buy it. That's really all you need to know to be able to do this. Now, how do you buy a stock? Is there like a stock store that you just walk down to the corner street and say, "Hey, I want 3 stocks in Samsung and 2 stocks in Apple"? No. But it is honestly almost that simple. Now, back in my day, or, you know, back a couple years ago before the internet, what you really had to do is you had to call somebody. This person would be known as a broker. And then you had to tell this person, hey, I want you to buy stocks in this company. And then the person would have to be okay, and he'd have to go to buy the stocks in the company. Sometimes things would change, so he'd have to call you back, and he'd be like, oh, hey, this changed, and you have to make the decision, and you call, and then he makes the decision, and then he purchases it, but then it's a lot of back and forth. And of course, to become one of these broker-type people, you have to go, become really smart, understand a bunch of complicated stuff. Luckily, nowadays, it is a lot simpler. So hear me, because with this, you will be able to trade and buy stocks super easily, okay? This is it. Get ready. Go to a website, right? Instead of people, we have websites and apps now. They're called broker apps and broker websites, okay? So you go to a broker app. You go to a broker website. Create an account there. Type in the name of the company that you want to buy or sell stocks, right? So choose a company, and then either hit the button that says buy or hit the button that says sell. That's it. That is as complicated as it gets when you want to understand how to purchase or sell a stock. It's literally like buying anything else on any other online store. That is the level of complication that you necessarily have to deal with. Now, there's a lot of these different apps and websites that you could go to, and they're all broker apps and broker websites. Now, you could just type in broker to the Google search engine and then choose one at random. I would not recommend you do this because there are scammers, and even if they're not, some of the brokers are better than others. So if you're seriously considering this, which I do recommend you seriously consider investing to some degree, there are a couple options. I will leave videos in the description that in-depth review which broker does what and which one is best for you. But for the sake of simplicity, there is an app. It's called Acorn. There's a good chance you've already heard of it. The way it works is that you purchase an item, whatever it be, whether it's gum, chips, whatever. Let's say, for instance, it's $1.30, right? Then you actually end up getting charged $2. The $1.30 goes to the pack of gum. And then the other 70 cents goes into the Acorn account. And then the Acorn account just automatically invests that 70 cents for you. So you literally have to do nothing other than create the account. As long as you're making enough purchases, then it will automatically invest everything for you, and that's how you make the money. Now, needless to say, it works significantly slower than any other option. But if you start young, you'll have a good portion of money later on. Obviously, how much money you make definitely depends on the kind of person you are and how many purchases you're making. But that is the simplest and easiest option for anybody who just wants to do it without thinking about it at all. If you want to invest more time into it and get more money out of it, what you could do is go to another broker app or website called, well, there's a bunch of them, but one of them is called Webull, and this one doesn't do anything automatically for you. You put money into your account, and then you buy and sell stuff, just as simple as I explained it. You go, you pick a company, you decide, hey, I want to purchase this stock, you purchase it, and then later you sell it. It literally has just buy and sell buttons. Now, what I will say is that it can get really complicated because it has a lot of features and shows you how stocks are moving up and down and yada, yada, yada. And it's not as complicated as it looks. It's just that if you're not used to this system, if you're not used to how investors think, then it's going to take you some time to readjust your brain to fully understand how everything works. It took me, honestly, about a week to fully understand most of its features and the features of a lot of these other broker apps. But once I understood it, I realized it's not complicated. It's just my brain needed a good portion of time to fully understand what everything meant. Now, if you want to invest more time and you want to actually, you know, make a good portion of money on this, then yeah, you need to go and understand how patterns work. You need to understand how to un- to know when things cost what, for sure. But once you understand everything I've just told you, understanding everything else becomes a lot more comprehensible. Now, another option you have is that you can actually find companies where you go and you give them $1,000, $2,000, whatever. You want to do research, obviously. You want to make sure these are reliable companies, because needless to say, there are a lot of scammers out there. But if you find one of these investment companies that have a good reputation, then they're generally a really good option, because you give them $1,000, $2,000, and you don't pay them. What they do is that they take a portion of the profit. Not a portion of what you gave them, but a portion of the money they made on what you gave them. So it behooves them to make sure that you succeed. And generally speaking, again, it depends on which company you're dealing with, but generally speaking, they will only make investments in things that they know won't make a lot of money immediately, but will make a lot of money over a long period of time. So they're slow like Acorn, but because you're giving them a lot more money and a lot more to manage and they have to worry about everything, you don't need to think about it, you actually end up making more money in the long run. So those different options honestly just depend on you as an individual, how much money you can give up. Maybe you can give up $1,000 immediately to make it later. Maybe you can only give up, 50 cents here and there to make it up later. Whichever one it is, choose wisely. Don't be stupid about this. And you will probably end up making a lot more money than otherwise. And I encourage just about everybody to do this, because as long as you can, even if it's just a little bit, and even if it's not money, obviously if it's a little bit, you're not going to have much money in the short term. But any of these methods can help you make money in the long term. So after you decide to retire, you are more likely to have money to spend after that point if that's the route you want to go. And a couple of you might have actually been inspired to make this your job, in which case you will have to do a heck of a lot more research to make this a viable job, but you could definitely do it. But even if you don't want to take that option, you can take the option of, let me do this a little bit so I have a lot more money in the long run. Now, one warning I want to give you. A lot of the time you'll see stocks just kind of go down, maybe even crash at some point. I'm going to tell you right now, do not panic. I can almost guarantee you, I can pretty much guarantee you, if you panic, you will lose money, regardless of which of these methods you choose out of the ones I've recommended or whatever other ones I may have forgot to mention you decide to go with. You will lose money if you panic. Understand the fundamental rule if you're doing whichever method. Stocks go down, they will come back up. The stock market in general goes up and down, up and down, and up and down, and up and down, and up and down. Do not panic if it goes down, because odds are, as long as you chose a company that probably won't go under, it's going to come back up. That is just how stocks work. People have a tendency to panic and sell when the stock goes down, even though it more than definitely will come back up. Now, if it's pretty certain that you need to cut your losses, or like you know that the company is going under, and you've calmly analyzed the situation and made the decision, your best option here is to get rid of the stock, then yeah, obviously at that point, sell the stock. But do not just panic and sell your stocks just because it briefly or for a significant portion of time goes down. Okay, odds are if you're doing that, you will lose money. So always stay calm. A lot of people tend to lose money during recessions, not because the companies went down or out of business, but because during those recessions, those companies had a significant period of time where their stock went down. And instead of just waiting for them to come back up, which most of them did, they just sold it and lost a heck of a lot of money. So do not panic. Please. One other thing is that there is another broker, again, you've probably heard about it, Robinhood. It's not a scam or anything, but I have yet to see anybody actually recommend Robinhood. The main reason is because it doesn't have a ton of information for advanced investors, and for new investors, it kind of throws everything at one place, but it microanalyzes everything, so it makes small dips in stocks seem like a much bigger deal than they actually are. So because of this, people end up are encouraged to make sporadic decisions buying and selling stocks. And because it doesn't make it super, super easy, or at least encourages you to look at long-term progress, people generally don't make the wisest decisions kind of just based on how it's set up. But yeah, so I hope this video helped. I think after watching this video, pretty much understanding anything else you want to know beyond this point, a lot more doable, because now you just understand the basics of how to sell and buy stocks. And now that I've said it, it probably seems super stupid simple to anybody watching this video, and really to especially investors. But the thing is that because it's stupid simple, people who are really experienced in it and are trying to advise new people kind of forget about it, because to them it's like, well, duh. But they forget that people who are new to this don't understand these very, very basic portions of how to purchase and sell things. But in any case, again, as I'm sure I've said like 5 times by now, I encourage most anybody to go ahead and invest in some way, shape, or form. Doesn't need to be super risky, doesn't need to be a heck of a lot of money. I just encourage you to do it to whatever degree suits you best, because in the long term, it'll probably benefit you. Well, guys, I hope... Wait, what's that? You made how much on GameStop? Oh my gosh. Uku, I'm never doubting you again. Well, guys, as I go and cry myself to sleep on the decisions I've made thus far in my financial endeavors, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any other ideas or comments, or just want to tell me how great of a job I did, leave it down in the comments section below. Otherwise, hit that subscribe button and that bell button. I post every other week, and until next time, hear nothing and listen to all. Bye, guys.